October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. The CDC says more than one in three women in the United States has been raped, physically abused, or stalked by someone they know. Joining me to discuss the importance of recognizing this month and the effort to involve men in stopping domestic violence is Isha Pandit, Executive Director of Men Stopping Violence. In the interest of transparency, I also serve on the board. If you follow me on Twitter or Facebook, I talk about it all the time, not just during Domestic Violence Awareness Month. But glad to have you here, Isha. I think we should talk about this all the time. Let's talk about Domestic Violence Awareness Month. It's the 25th anniversary of this month. It seemed most people know that this is this month, but there was a time when we didn't talk about this.
No, and that was why Domestic Violence Awareness Month even started, was to bring awareness to the issue, to the fact that domestic violence is in fact a problem. And I think it's a blessing that we have Domestic Violence Awareness Month. It's also a commentary that it's been 25 years and violence is still the leading cause of injury to women. Domestic violence is still the leading cause of injury to women in the United States, more than car accidents, muggings, and rapes combined.
Which is why we still need this month.
Absolutely.
I know you came prepared to talk about some of the common myths that's in our dialogue. We'll get to that in a moment. But I think before we do, actually, let's talk about how the mission of Men Stopping Violence is a little bit different than some of the other groups that are out there. Talk about that.
So Men Stopping Violence is an organization that believes that we need to have men engaged on ending violence against women. We believe that everyone needs to be involved, and we don't think that violence against women is going to stop unless men get engaged. So we do all different kinds of programs with men. We do intervention programs with men who have been perpetrators of violence and work with them. And we also work with communities and men in the community to talk about prevention, how we can stop this from happening. So we have a great program, for example, called Because We Have Daughters, which is about fathers and daughters and about building safe communities for girls, starting in the home.
Fantastic. Okay, now let's get through some of these myths, which is the point of an awareness month, is to raise awareness. What are some of the most common myths about domestic violence?
I think the first most common myth is that it doesn't happen or that it's less common than it is. I think one in four women will experience domestic violence at the hands of a partner or former partner as adults. That's the first one, that this is happening, that there's a lot of silence around it. Another common myth is that women lie about violence. They, in fact, don't. Most commonly, women understate the violence that they're experiencing in the home. People often say women provoke men to commit violence, that it has something to do with an interpersonal relationship. Sometimes it does, but most often violence happens because there's so much silence around it, and we enable it to happen, and we don't speak out against it. People feel shame in speaking out, and so that enables perpetrators to continue committing it.
One that I hear a lot is that people say that it happens within certain income brackets more often than others, or with certain racial groups more often than others. I hear that one quite a bit.
That's right. And people say that often, and it is statistically untrue, that violence happens more within poor communities or in communities of color. Violence happens across the board, and there's silence and stigma and shame across the board.
Okay. All right. So what can people do if they would like to make a difference?
Well, there's a lot of things people can do. The first is to really be connected to it in your own communities. Pay attention to what's happening in the places where you live, to the people and friends and family that you know. Speak out. Become a voice. Become a safe space for people to come and talk to, find out about your shelters. If you're interested in working on with men and figuring out how we can involve men in this work, you can go to menstoppingviolence.org. We're 30 years old this year. It's our 30th anniversary. So we're really proud of our experience and our success in working with men. And I would love to talk to anyone who wants to learn more about how to do that.
And I'm going to brag a little. We're celebrating, actually, with a very big dinner at the end of the month. All that information is also on our website, menstoppingviolence.org. And we're also honoring a pioneer in nonviolence, Congressman John Lewis, who was our very first. I bragged about being on the board. He way predates me. He was our very first board president, in fact.
Yes, yes. We're really excited about making sure this conversation keeps happening and that we really begin to change the culture of violence in our communities.
Okay, and we're going to talk about this all month. I'm going to bring in some other organizations as well, some survivors as well, and some men who will acknowledge that they have been offenders and they're trying to change and make a difference. Isha, thank you for starting off the month and starting the conversation. I appreciate it
very
much.
Thank you for having me, Richelle.
Absolutely.